Father, we come to you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, today I ask that you would open up our eyes and let us see what we've never seen before. I pray that you'd open up our ears and let us hear what your Spirit is saying right now to this house. Father, let our hearts be soft and receptive to everything you'd speak to us today. Father, I thank you today that miracles are going to take place in this house because of Jesus. So we love you and we trust you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. How many of you would like to work the works of God? How many would like to destroy the works of the devil? How many want to do the works of God and cast out those nasty devils that are tormenting your friends and family members, that are trying to come into your house and mess with your kids, mess with your wife, mess with your husband? Listen to this right here. Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God. This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he sent." You know, there are a lot of people who run after God for what he can do for them. If you prosper me, I'm going to try Jesus. We have a try Jesus generation right now. That's just crazy. I want God to be able to use me to do the works of God. Jesus said, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he sent." The greatest work that we can do is draw up close to him. The Bible says in James, draw close to him and he will draw close to you. I want to know and I want to walk in the power of God. I don't want theologies. I don't want philosophies. I want the power of God, because I've been touched in my own life through relationships, through family members, through friends who have been stung with the sting of death, who have been stung with the bite of cancer, who have been stung with divorce and pain and heartache. And you want to do something and you feel like in my own strength, I can't do anything. How many ever been there before where you're like, I would give my own life if I could, but still that won't help the situation. The Bible says that God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. If he said it, he will do it. If you have sickness in your body, listen, if you're bound by drugs or sexual immorality or homosexuality, sexual perversion, alcoholism, depression, if you're being oppressed by the devil, today, if you'll just believe in him, if you'll just believe in him, if you'll just believe in Jesus, power will be made available today to deliver you and set you free. That's who he is. God backs up his name. He said, "I'm the bread of life. I'm the door. I'm the way, the truth, truth and the life." Jesus is the healer. He is the ultimate conqueror. He is the King of kings and Lord of lords. It's Jesus. Jesus is the hope for this generation. Say Jesus. Nothing shall be impossible with God. If you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. Jesus said, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. Lord, I believe. Help my unbelief. Eliminate and remove every voice of doubt. Lord, I believe. Help me where I don't believe. And I thought, if I can get one thing in life, if I can get one thing, I want to lay hold of him. Can you believe in him? Can you believe in him? Get a hold of Jesus. And if you have Jesus, then you have access to everything else that you need. Amen.